感谢神又再次的把我们领回他的家中来敬拜他，让我们每个人都安静和预备我们的心，并且把我们的手机关至静音或者关闭，让我们用心灵和诚实来敬拜我们的主。
Thank the Lord for once again bringing us back to His house. Let us quiet our heart and let's turn our phone in silent or turn it off completely. And let's come before Him and worship Him in truth and spirit.
好，让我们一起祷告。
Let us pray.
我们亲爱的天父，我们满心感谢赞美你。
Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you.With all of our hearts, and we praise you.
感谢你用你的爱再次的聚集你的众儿女，回到你的家中敬拜你。
Thank you that through your love you have gathered all your children back into your house to worship you.
感谢你先爱了我们。
And we thank you that you have loved us first.
你的爱是如此的长阔高深。
Your love is such deep and such wide.
为了爱我们，你赐下了你的独生爱子，舍命流血做我们的赎价。
And because that you have loved us, you have given us your only begotten Son to shed His precious blood and sacrifice His life for us.
我们要用最美、最动听的歌声来赞美你。
We need to praise you with our best voice.
我们要用心灵和诚实来敬拜你。
And we need to worship you in truth and spirit.
求你的圣灵与我们同在，也求你悦纳我们的侍奉和摆上。
May the Holy Spirit be with us, and may you accept our offering.
恳求祷告是奉主耶稣基督的圣名，阿门。
We pray in Jesus' victorious name.
Amen.
下面让我们一起来唱诗歌第八首《荣耀归于真神》，请起立。
Please rise, let's sing together. To God be the glory.
Oh, God.
We'll begin our worship today.
下面让我们一起来诵读诗篇106篇第一节。
Our call to worship today is in Psalms 1, chapter 106, verse 1.
你们要赞美耶和华，
要
称谢耶
和
华，
因
他
本
为善，
他
的慈爱
永
远
长
存。
Praise the Lord. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever.
Amen.
Amen.
下面让我们一起起立来唱诗歌第十八首，你的信实广大。
Please rise, let's sing, Great is thy faithfulness. Our Father in Heaven, we thank you and we praise you.
感谢你用你的平安再一次的带领你的众儿女回到了你的殿中，来到了你的施恩宝座前来敬拜你。
Thank you that through the peace within you, you have brought us back to your temple, and that we could come before your throne of grace to worship you.
主，你是永不改变的真神。
Lord, you are the true living God that's never changing.
你是昔在、今在、永在的全能者。
And you are the Almighty One that's in the past, present, and future.
你是我们坚强的后盾，你是我们不可转移的磐石。
You are the never-changing rock, and you are our biggest strong hope.
我们感谢你，无论这个环境如何的动荡不安，你时刻的保守你的众儿女有属天的平安和喜乐。
And we are full of thanks, and no matter how the environment is full of tribulation and changes, that we have the peace coming from you from above.
也感谢你赐给我们，不管在生活上还是我们属灵的造就上，你都赐下丰富的供应，使我们没有缺乏。
And we thank you for your provision, whether it be in our everyday life or in our spiritual life.
主啊，同时也求你扶持和怜悯我们的惧怕和软弱。
And may you hold us and may you have mercy upon us in all our fears and our weaknesses.
求你加添我们的力量。
And may you give us more strength.
使我们的日子如何，力量也如何。
So as our days go by, so is our strength.
我们为此把一切的颂赞荣耀都归给你。
We give all our thanks, our praise, and our glory to you.
我们也把以下的崇拜、恭敬的仰望交托在你的恩手当中。
And we commit our worship into your hands.
求你的圣灵运行在我们每一个人的心中。
May your Holy Spirit dwell among the hearts of every one of us.
求你洁净我们的身心灵。
And may you cleanse our heart, our body, and our spirit.
让我们每一个人都可以守节清心和谦卑顺服的来到你的面前，俯伏在你的脚前。
So that we could come before you and we kneel before you.And we obey you with a cleansed hand and pure heart.
也使我们每一个肢体，我们每一颗心，都因为你的爱可以合而为一。
So that every one of us that's a member of your body and all our hearts, we could come before you in unity.
主啊，也求你用你圣洁的膏油，恩膏为你开口的仆人，圣牧师和所有的同工。
And may you anoint our pastor song and all your servant.
同时也求你祝福所有的会众，不管是在线下或者是在家中的弟兄姐妹，求你同样祝福他们。
And may you bless all the members, whether we're here physically or we're watching online.
求你亲自的来对我们说话。
May you personally speak to each and every one of us.
主啊，我们知道靠着我们自己，我们无法做到一个让你满意的孩子。
Oh Lord, we know that through our own strength, we cannot be a children that pleases you.
就求你用你的话语再一次的激励我们，感动我们，光照我们，还有带领我们。
May you personally touch us with your words and let us be determined.
也求你不断地打磨我们，塑造我们更像你。
And may you continue to carve us and shape us to be more like you.
让我们可以以基督的心为心，活出你的爱。
So that we have the heart of our Lord Jesus and we may manifest and live out your love.
也可以使我们在行事为人上与我们所蒙的恩相称。
And in our everyday life and our action, that we are worthy of the salvation and grace coming from you.
主啊，求你帮助我们在这样的末世，可以让我们更加的警醒自守，坚固我们的信心，紧紧的走在你的真道上，不偏离。
And may you help us and give us strength in the end time, that we could be awakened and alerted.That we walk on the path of righteousness and the path of truth.
我们再一次把 荣耀颂赞都归于我们在天上的父。
Once again, we give glory, all our thanks and praises to our Father in heaven.
恳求祷告是奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
We pray in Jesus' victorious name.
Amen.
Amen. 请坐。
Please be seated.
下面是奉献的时间，请司献的姐妹到台前来。
Now is the time for offering. Please rise, let's sing the doxology. Our Father in heaven, we thank you and we praise you.
我感谢你，你的爱把我们聚集在一起。
We thank you that your love has gathered us together.
我们现在献上感恩的标记。
Now we offer you a token of our gratitude.
求你使用。
May you use it.
也求你祝福所有甘心乐意奉献的人。
And may you bless all those that are willingly to give.
我们再次把美国交在你的手中。
Once again, we commit America into your hands.
我感谢你这次全力的交接，顺利，没有流血。
We thank you that during the president inauguration that it came in a peaceful manner and there's no bloodshed.
我也求你，让执政掌权的人能够以圣经的原则来管理这个国家。
And we ask that you may.The ruler at the moment will rule this country according to your words and your teaching.
所以我们要将我们教会每一个弟兄姐妹交你手中。
Lord, once again, we commit each and every one of us into your hand.
也求你看顾我们的需要。
May you look after our needs.
把我们当中身体有软弱的、有病痛的都交你手中。
Those among us that is physically weak or that is sick, we commit them into your hand.
我为着阿罕姐妹，为着朱迪姐妹来祷告。
We pray for Sister Ahan and Sister Judy.
为着 Maple 姐妹祷告。
We pray for Sister Maple.
Harry Chong 弟兄祷告。
Brother Harry Chong.
他们身体上无论哪一方面的软弱，求你都为他们担当，医治他们。
No matter what kind of weakness they have in the body, may you bear for them and you cure them.
现在。还没有回到教会来聚会的弟兄姐妹，求你也与他们同在。
Those brothers and sisters that have not returned to the church, may you also be with them.
让他们无论在什么地方都记得来敬拜你。
So that no matter where they are, they remember to come before you and worship.
主啊，我们也求你看顾我们教会的年轻人、小孩子。
And may you, Lord, may you look after.The young people and the children of our church.
让他们在这个世界上能够听到你的话语，不受魔鬼撒旦或者世界的引诱。
So that they may listen to your words and not be lured by the world and the devil.
也求你今天赐给我们有个受教的心。
And may you give us a teachable heart today.
让我们听到也行道。
So that we not only listen, but we also take action.
我们这时候纪念主耶稣在地上教导他的门徒，这样祷告说。
We remember what the Lord on earth told his disciples and said.
我们在天上的父，
愿人都尊你的名为圣。
愿你的国降临，
愿
你的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。我们日用的饮食，今日赐给我们，免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债。不叫我们遇见试探，救我们脱离凶恶。因为国度、权柄、荣耀，全是你的，直到永远。阿门。大家请坐。
Please be seated.
下面是读经的时间，让我们一起，让我们一起来读《使徒行传》第十五章第三十六节。
Our scripture reading is in the book of Acts, chapter 15, verse 36.
过了些日子，保罗对巴拿巴说：“我们可以回到从前宣传主道的各城。”看望弟兄们景况如何。
Then after some days, Paul said to Barnabas, "Let us now go back and visit our brethren in every city where we have preached the word of the Lord and see how they are doing."
Barnabas.
Barnabas.
下面是正道的时间，有请孙牧师为我们传讲信息。我们的景况如何？
The message by our pastor today is, How are we doing? Let's welcome him. Brothers and sisters, peace. The scripture we have just read.It said that Paul went and visited Barnabas and all the brethren to see how they're doing.
我读到这里呢，我就记得，我们经常见面的时候都是问，Steve, how are you doing? 问他。
When I see Pastor Sun, I say, Pastor Sun, how are you doing?
Okay, 当我们问这句话的时候，我们就关心这个人的情况如何。
So when we ask this question, we care about how they've been doing recently.
那这个我记得有一句话，经常很多人愿意讲说，你就做自己的事，不管别人怎么看。
I remember there's a saying that many people say is mind your own business.
Just do your own.
Do your own thing.
我们呢，很多时候就是我只顾自己。那不管别人怎么看。
Many times we only care about ourselves and we do not care about what other people are doing.
讲这句话的人呢，其实呢，他就认为圣经里头所讲的这位神不存在。
So the people that speak these kind of words, they do not believe in the Bible and they don't think that God exists.
在他们的眼里，圣经里头呢，没有所谓的对错。
To their eyes, the Bible do not have a right or wrong.
也没有所谓的来生。
And there is not an afterlife.
那我们基督徒是不是也是跟他们一样呢？
But us as Christians, are we the same?
因为基督徒呢，跟别人不同呢，我们是相信有一位神。
Us as Christians, our difference is we believe in the God.
我们相信圣经是绝对的真理。
And we believe that the Bible is the absolute truth.
神的话是有绝对的权柄和尊荣。
And the words of God have the absolute power and glory.
其实神把我们放在这个地上。
When God placed us on this earth.
也是把我们放在各种各样的关系之中。
He also put us in different relationships.
首先一种关系呢，就是我们跟神之间的关系。
The first relationship is our relationship with God.
我们在家里跟其他人之间的关系。
And our relationship in our family with others.
然后呢，我们在教会里跟弟兄姐妹之间的关系。
And also our relationship in church with our brothers and sisters.
还有我们在我们现在美国， 我们作为国民跟这个政府之间的关系。
And also us loving America as a citizen, our relationship with the government.
我们要想想，我们跟在不同的场合，在不同的关系中，我们是怎么样处理的
？So we have to think about in different environment and situation, how do we handle our relationship?
现代人他们很崇尚自由。
The modern people in this age, they love freedom.
他们没有尊重权柄。
And they do not honor the authority.
也没有尊荣权柄。
And they do not give glory to the authority.
现代人的想法呢，虽然权柄摆在他们上面，他们没办法逃脱。
And the mindset of people today is even though they have the authority above them, but they cannot escape it.
但是呢，他们有对待权柄的自己的一套看法。
But they have their own opinion and their perspective regarding the authority.
对基督徒来讲呢，我们知道我们的绝对权柄就是神。
But to us Christians, we know that our absolute authority is God.
你承认这个权柄的时候，你所有的生活、言语、一切的一切，你都要尊主为大。
If you acknowledge this authority, then your life, yourself as a whole, that you give all to God.
我们要做神喜悦的事情。
We need to do the things that God loves.
啊，我们做他所喜悦的事情，我们就可以从他那里得到祝福和赏赐。
And if we do the things that pleases God, then from Him we could receive His blessing.
那现在的人不相信神的时候，就说神跟我无关。
But to people that does not believe in God, then God does not matter to them.
我做我的事情有没有神没有关系。
I do my own business, and if there's a God or not, I don't really care.
我没有必要去顺服他，没有必要去尊荣他。
I do not need to obey him or give him glory.
我就是我自己的权柄。
I am my own authority.
我要尊荣的是尊荣我自己。
And I give glory to myself.
所以这个是现代人的想法。
This is the mindset of modern people.
所以他们随口就万称主的名。
So whatever they speak, they call God's name
in vain.
Here in vain.
你看这个在英文里头呢，随随便便就用神的名字。没有一点的尊敬。
Therefore, in our everyday speaking, the word God is mentioned in vain and carelessly.
甚至用神的话去骂人，用神的名去骂人。
And to the point that they even use God's name to curse at each other.
然后呢，就用神的名作为他说话的感叹号，的标点符号。
And they even use God's name as an exclamation mark in the sentence.
因为他们里面不信神，就他这个可以对神的名字，随便任意。
It's because they do not believe in God, so they could use God's name to their own wish.
所以今天呢，我们作为信神的人，我们不能跟他们一样。
But today, as us, as people that believe in God, we cannot be the same.
我们对神的名，对神的权柄，我们要绝对的顺服以尊荣。
For God's name and God's authority, we have to absolutely obey it.
那世人他们也尊荣某一些权柄，也顺服某一些权柄。
People on earth, but they also give glory and they obey certain authority.
而且他们的尊荣还有顺服都是带条件的。
But giving glory and obeying the authority, there's a price.
比如说尊敬老师。
For example, respecting teacher.
他不是因为他是老师我就尊敬他。
It's not because it's their teacher, so I respect it.
在这个是中国跟这个美国不同的地方。
And this is the cultural difference between China and America.
中国人呢就是说要尊师重教。
To Chinese people, we have to obey our teacher and honor our teacher.
是因为他是老师，我就尊敬他。
It's because they are the teacher, that's why we honor them.
那美国呢？不是因为他是老师我尊敬他，是因为他是好老师，我就尊敬他。如果他这个老师呢，不那么好，我就不一定尊敬他了。
But in America, not only they have to be a teacher, but they have to be a good teacher for me to respect him. If he's not a good teacher, then I will not pay my respect.
20 years ago,我刚来美国，这做文化交流。
20 years ago, when I first come to America for culture exchange,
我去过小学、幼儿园、中学。初中跟高中。
I went to elementary, kindergarten, junior high, and high school.
我是从中国来，中国那边呢，老师一进门的那个直升声是起立，所有的人就站起来，表示尊敬。
And when I came from China, the classroom in China, when teacher enters into the door, every student stands up to pay respect.
那这里呢，老师进去，他们在那里还一边在吃冰棍。一边就有些根本就是当你没来。
But over here, when the teacher enters into the classroom, some are eating, and some act like the teacher hasn't even arrived.
那老师在那里讲课的时候，他突然间那个人就跑出去去买汽水，买可口可乐喝了。
And during the middle of the lecture, someone would get up to buy sodas.
我那时候就觉得是说，我不能接受这样。
And at that time,It's something that I cannot accept.
所以在这个社会，其实有很多的国家，他们要尊敬一个人，他们都是有条件的。
Therefore, in many countries in our society, to respect somebody, they have to pay a price.
甚至对于父母
，even to the parents.
在这个华人的文化里头，因为你是父母，我就尊敬你。
Even in our Asian society, as a parent, I respect you.
但是呢，在国外的说，如果你这个父母呢对我好啊，给我东西，那我可以尊敬你。但是你如果没有的话，他不一定尊敬你。
But in other society, as a parent, if you provide for me, then I respect you. But if you do not do that, then I won't.
然后对政府也是这样。
And to the government, it's the same matter.
如果这个总统或者政府没有给我很多好处，我就出门到任何地方骂总统骂政府。
If the government or the president did not give me the benefits, then everywhere I go, I will badmouth them.
那我们基督徒是不是能跟世人一样？ But, 我们对什么人尊敬？对神什么人尊荣，我们都是用他这些人来满足我的要求，满足我的需要，我才尊敬他们。
But as Christian, are we the same? To pay respect to certain people, we need them to benefit us and meet our requirements.
我们首先来看我们跟神之间的关系。
First, let's look at our relationship with God.
我们知道神。创造了我们，给我们生命。
We know that God has created us and gave us life.
而且呢，我们离了他，我们一天都活不下去。
And we know that without Him, we cannot live a single day.
相不相信
？Do you believe that?
我们知道空气是神所造的，阳光也是神所造的。如果神把这些东西拿掉的话，我们一分钟都不能活下去。
We know the air, the light is all created by God. And if God have taken them away, then we cannot live a single day.
他甚至当我们犯罪的时候，他来替我们死。
And even to the point that when we have sinned, He came and died for us.
这些呢，都是他为我们已经做了的事情。
And these are all the things that He have already done for us.
所以我们来到他的面前。
Therefore, when we come before Him,
我们是不是要顺服他
？Do we need to obey Him?
我们是不是要尊荣他
？Do we need to give Him the glory?
我们如果你仔细想，那他是主，所以圣经里头说我们要爱他，我们要把身体献上当作活祭。圣经里头都用一个词叫做理所当然。
Therefore, in the Bible, it says we need to love Him and offer our body as a living sacrifice. And it says,
these are all reasonable services.
It's a reasonable service.
就是按理应该是这样。
Therefore, we do it because we have to do it. It's reasonable.
但是今天呢，好多基督徒不是这样。
But today, many Christians is not like this.
要我尊顺服这位神，要我尊荣这位神。
You want me to obey this God? You want me to give honor and glory to this God?
如果他让我这个中彩票，我就顺服他。
If he let me win the lottery, then I will obey him.
啊，听我祷告。
If you listen to my prayer.
啊，让我中大奖，让我发财，我就尊荣他，我就顺服他。
Let me hit the jackpot. Let me gain a lot of wealth. Then I will obey him.
很多人，我为什么要做礼拜？礼拜是尊敬神啊，尊荣神神。但是我的祷告，他一直都没有听，所以我不去了。
A lot of people, why do I go to church? I come to worship. It's because I honor him. But he does not listen to my prayer, so I'm not going to attend anymore.
我讲这个，其实呢，就是这个多年的基督徒或多或少，我们也有这种想法。
The reason I mention this is, as a Christian for many years, more or less we have this kind of mindset.
啊，有一些人生了很多年的病，然后神啊，你如果不医治我，我也不信你了。
Some people, they have been sick for many years, and they say, God, if you do not cure me, then I no longer want to believe in you.
Okay. 我在两个月前，在我一个来到我们教会很长一段时间的一个人写了一个帖子给我。
About 2 months ago, a person that's been coming to our church wrote me a message.
他说，我现在就祷告某某人要当上总统。
He said, I will pray right now that so and so will become the president.
如果这个人最后没有当上总统，我也不信了。
If this person in the end did not become the president, then I will no longer believe.
他说，我很简单，你要我这个继续做礼拜，继续信。那因为这个某某人，我认为他是能够做一个好总统，那我就为他祷告。如果某某人当不了总统，那这位神呢、啊，也靠不住，所以我不信。
He said, I'm simple. I come to church. I believe in you, and I think this person is a great president. And if you do not let him become a president, then you're not a great God, and I don't want to believe in you anymore.、
啊、我们知道，现在总统选举已经确定了。
And right now we already know who's the new president.
结果呢，这个人要的那个人没有当总统。
But the person that the president that this person want did not become the president.
所以这个人呢也退群了，就再也没有在我的这个朋友圈里头啊找到他了，他退群了。
So.Therefore, this person left all church social media group.
在他的教导下，他的儿子也是这个样。
And in, under his teaching, his children did the same thing.
他一个唯一的儿子在找工作。
And his only son is, his children, the only son is looking for work.
然后他也是讲说，他的儿子就是要去当兵。
And he said that his son,needs to go to the army.
他说神如果垂听他祷告，让他顺利的当了兵，他就会继续信神，然后还会给教会拿很多奉献。
He said if God continue and listen to his prayer, let his son successfully join the army, then he will continue to believe in God and pay a lot of tribute and offering.
Okay. 结果呢，你猜他的儿子当了兵吗？
And guess what happened? Did his son became a part of the army?
没有。
He did not.
Okay, 所以他儿子呢，本来来我们教会有一段时间也不见了。
So therefore, his son that came to our church for a period of time also stopped coming.
啊，所以每次看到这的时候，我就觉得我们人真的是非常的可恶。
And when I see these kind of situations, that I think that us as human, we are full of wickedness.
啊，神造了我们，拯救我们，不是我们要满足他什么条件。他才拯救我们，才爱我们。
God has saved us and has gave us the salvation. It's not that we have done something for Him, that He have done such things.
啊，有一个传道人在传道的时候，我听了我非常的不同意。
There's one preacher when he's preaching that I heard his message and I disagree.
他做了一个比方，他说神。爱我们拣选我们就像一个人跑到孤儿院里头看有很多小孩每一个都在等待有人把他领养、
He said that God has saved us and chosen us just like a person that has visited an orphanage and see many children is waiting to be adopted
然后他看了、哎这个小孩比较可爱所以就把这个小孩抱走这个领养他、
And then he looked at one children, and this children is cute, so he adopted that children.
然后他就讲说，我们就是这样小可爱的小孩。
And he said that we are just like this children. We are cute and lovable.
我有时候在看看镜子，我真的一点都不可爱。
But when I look at the mirror, I don't think I'm cute.
真的，我。有很多罪，有很多不堪的东西，真的不值得神来爱我们。
Because I have so much sin and so much filth that it's not worthy of God's love.
Okay, 那么这个讲到神跟我们之间的关系。
So talking about the relationship between God and us.
因为神无条件的爱我们，拯救我们，所以我们顺服他，尊敬他，也必须是无条件的。
Because God loves us unconditionally, therefore, for us to obey Him and follow His will, it also has to be unconditional.
然后我们再讲另外一种关系，就是家庭里的关系。
And the other relationship is our relationship in our family.
家庭是神在这个世界上，除了他跟人之间以外的所建立的第一种关系。
The family is the first relationship on this earth beside God.
家庭的关系先于教会跟我们之间的关系。
The relationship in family is the first
prior
to the relationship between us and the church.
家庭的关系也先于国家跟我们之间的关系。
And the relationship of our family is also prior to our relationship with the government.
所以家庭的关系呢，是在我们人与人之间的最重要的关系。
Therefore, the relationship of our family is the most important for us between person to person.
那这个关系里头呢，神也是有要求的。
And in such relationship, God have His requirements.
一个家庭的成立必须有丈夫跟妻子。
To establish a family, there must be a husband and a wife.
那丈夫跟妻子呢，他都有各自要做的事情。
And for the husband and the wife, they all have their own duties.
对丈夫，神的要求是什么
？To a husband, what is God's requirement?
是要爱妻子。
Is to love his wife.
那爱妻子，我们都有爱，我们可以爱很多东西。
But and to love our wife, we all have love, but we also could love many other things.
我们爱是有程度的。
So our love, there has to be a level to it.
我们爱妻子要爱到一个什么地步呢
？How deep do we have to love our wife?
我以前啊，我以前在读圣经的时候，我就很喜欢一句话，叫做爱人如己。
When I read the Bible, there's a line I love is to love others as yourself.
在原文的是love your neighbor as yourself.
And in the original text is, love your neighbor as yourself.
啊，就是你邻居那里，在家庭里头，你的邻居是谁啊？
So in your family, who's your neighbor? 啊，
对丈夫来讲就是他妻子，对妻子来讲就是他丈夫，他最近的邻居。
To a husband, it's his wife, and to the wife, it's her husband. 啊
，OK， 那我爱他如同我自己，我觉得这个已经够厉害了。
So if I love them as myself, I think that's good enough.
在如果是这样的话，我觉得我做得不错。
So if I have done such, then I think I did a good job.
很多人都会觉得我不错。
Many people will think they've done a good job.
那是神不是这样要求啊。
But that's not what God wants.
神说，你爱妻子要像基督爱教会一样，为教会舍命。
He said that you have to love your wife just like our Lord Christ have loved the church and sacrificed his life for the church.
所以这样的话呢，也就是我们无论怎么爱，我们都没办法达到神的要求。
So this is saying that no matter how much we love, we cannot meet the requirement of God.
所以圣经里头说，凡事不可亏欠人。
Therefore, in the Bible, it says.Never fall short of anyone.
唯有爱要常以为亏欠。
Only that in love you have to always feel that you fall short.
就是说，你无论爱怎么爱妻子，你都会觉得说我爱不够，就是常以为亏欠。
And to always feel that you fall short in love is no matter how much you love your wife, you have to always feel that you don't love enough.
Okay, 那怎么样？这个妻子要怎么样顺服丈夫呢
？And how does the wife need to obey the husband？
啊，圣经里头讲说，妻子要顺服丈夫，如同教会顺服基督一样，要在凡事上顺服。
It says in the Bible that the wife need to obey the husband just like the church obey our Lord Jesus in all things.
OK， 那我们刚才讲说，人呢？往往就是在这个做什么事情之前，我们要加上一个条件。
But we mentioned before that us as humans in everything we do, there must be a condition for it.
Okay, 那这个我今天早上在华盛那边就讲，人家的条件就是这样。那个妻子对丈夫讲说，要我顺服你，你如果能够像基督那样爱我，我就顺服你没有问题。
And fortunately, I mentioned already that for a wife, the condition for a wife to love the husband is that to obey the husband is that if you love me like Jesus, then I will obey you.
啊，那这丈啊，那个丈夫说，我爱你。如果你能够像教会那样顺服基督的话，我爱你一点问题都没有。
Then the husband said that I can love you, but if you obey.Like the church obey Jesus.
那他讲这句话呢，是说，我现在爱你，要看你的表现。
So it means that I love you now, but according to what you're doing, your actions.
你要先顺服到一个地步，彻底的凡事上顺服，这时候我就可以考虑来爱你。
You have to obey in everything, and then I will consider to love.
这些都是人设的，就是我刚才所讲的。
And these are all set by man, by human.
神的要求，要我们处理好这个家里的关系，家里的最主要的关系，丈夫跟妻子都是不加任何条件的。你该顺服的，你就彻底顺服；你该爱的，你就。完完全全的舍命的去爱。
But the requirement by God to manage our relationship in our family is unconditional. If you need to obey, then you will obey unconditionally. If you need to love, you will love unconditionally.
这都是圣经的教导。
This is all the teaching of the Bible.
人现在呢，我讲的这几种关系，这两种关系，都出很多问题，很大的问题。
And the above two relationships I have mentioned, there has been many problems.
人跟神之间有没有问题？
Between us and God, do we have problems?
有没有？
Do we have problems?
问题很大。
Yes, we have big problems.
就是大家都在那里，他要信神，要神来为他做事，他才信他。
It's they believe in God and they expect something from God. They want God to do work on them.
现在家庭出现问题。
And now that family have problems.
很在美国。他们讲说两对夫妻就有一对离婚。
They say America, in every two couple, there's one that's getting divorced.
因为大家都在等对方先满足那些条件。
Because the other one is waiting for the other to meet their requirement.
我等了一辈子，太太都没有完完全全的顺服我。
I wait my whole lifetime and my wife still have not completely obeyed me.
所以我的爱就没办法施展出去。
Therefore, I cannot love her as much.
OK, 太太呢说，我一直在等我丈夫舍身的爱我，但等了一辈子，他都不那么爱我，所以呢，我也就是我的顺服也省了吧。
And the wife said, I've been waiting for the unconditional love from the husband, but he have never loved me as such, so I will not obey him completely.
所以一个家庭一个家庭的，一对夫妻一对夫妻的，散掉散架。
Therefore, families and families, wife and husband and wife and husband, they've been separated.
好，我们下面来看教会。
Now let's look at the church.
在教会里头呢，我们知道教会很多人很喜欢基督是教会的元首，我们大家都顺服他。
We know that in church, everyone agrees that Jesus Christ is the head of the church.
可以吗？是不是大家都顺服基督
？Everyone agrees, right?
OK, 所以在基督里，在教会里头呢，我要做什么？那我就随我自己觉得，我看为对的事情，我就去做。
So in church, whatever I want to do, I do what's right in my eye.
但是圣经里头呢有讲说，神在教会设立了监督，有没有
？But in the Bible, it says that God have established people that
oversees
the church.
神在教会里头还设立了牧师，有没有？
God have set pastor in the church, right?
这个神在教会里头也设立了教师，有没有
？God also set teachers in the church, right?
Okay, 但是有些人讲说，我有圣灵教导我，你是谁？我不用你教。
But some say I have the Holy Spirit guiding me. Who are you? I do not need to learn from you.
我不需要你的牧师来牧养我，我自己牧养自己。
I do not need the pastor to teach me. I could teach myself.
但是圣经里头不是这样的教导。
But in the Bible, it doesn't say that.
神在教会里头，他说他首先设立的是什么？使徒，然后还有教师、牧师，这些都是神所设立的。
But it says God in the church. There's first the disciples, and then there's apostles.
然后神在教会里头还设立长老
，and then there's also the elders
啊，所以这些呢，其实呢就是要我们将该给他的尊荣来归给他。
And this is for us to give him the honor and glory。
那我们都是，其实我们尊敬某一个人，在教会里头尊敬某个人，都是因为。主要我们去尊敬的。
And we honor somebody in church, it's because our Lord wants us to do it.
然后呢，我们要彼此相爱。
And we have to love one another.
不要有任何的条件。
And there must be no conditions.
因为圣经里头说我们要彼此相爱，是因为神是先爱了我们，所以我们要彼此相爱。
And it said in the Bible that we have to love one another.Because God have loved us first.
有一些人呢，这个要爱别人呢，那首先 有一个条件，就这个人必须可爱。
And for some, in order for them to love another, there's a condition that this person must be lovable.
如果这个人不可爱，叫我去爱他，那对不起。
If this person is not lovable, then I'm sorry, I cannot love you.
那圣经里头叫我们，这个是神主的命令，我们只要他是弟兄，只要他是弟姐妹，我们就不能恨，我们只能爱。
But in the Bible, it's the order of our Lord. As long as they are our brothers or sisters, we have to love them.
而且圣经里头呢，说侍奉神的人，我们要尊重他。
And in the Bible, it says all those that service God, we have to honor them.
啊，圣经里头说，若有人侍奉我，我父必尊重他。
It says if the person served me, then my father will honor him.
不管你是什么人，你没有任在教会里头没不担任任何的职位，那只要你侍奉神，所有的人，包括监督、长老、牧师，所有的人都要尊重你。
So you could be in church and you could not hold any position, but as long as you serve the Lord, then all the pastors, deacons, the elders, all will honor you.
所以，无论他是谁，他在这里，在那里，他做翻译或者做主席，他在侍奉神的时候，就值得我们所有的会众去尊敬这个人。
So no matter who they are, if they are a hymn leader, if they are a worship leader, their interpreter, doesn't matter who they are. As long as they're serving, we need to honor them.
你尊重他，就是尊重那个差派他来侍奉他的神。
And to honor them is to honor God who have sent them.
如果我们在教会里头知道这处理这些关系的话，教会就能够同心，教会就不会乱。
And if in church we know how to obey and manage this relationship, then our church will be in the same spirit and will be in the unity, and there's no conflict.
然后下面我们讲到国家。
Now we will talk about nations, country.
国家我们经常在圣经里头说是这些人叫做执政掌权的人。
In the Bible, it says that these are the rulers, the ones in authority.
罗马书十三章一到七节告诉我们说，在上掌权的人，人人都当尊敬。
In Romans chapter 13, verse 1 through 7, it says, those that are in power all have to honor them.
不是因为他们做了好事，或者他们做了什么东西，我们要去尊敬他们。
It's not because they have done good deeds or anything that we have to honor them.
就是我们在态度上，我们一定要尊敬他们。
But it's in our attitude that we have to honor and respect them.
我记得余传道有一次在查经的时候讲到，这个我们尊敬他们，顺服他们跟顺从他们是有不同的。
I remember once a preacher, you in Bible study said that we honor them and obey them, but it's different from following them.
等到主耶稣升天以后，门徒就开始在使徒行传里头，他们在那里到处传扬主耶稣的福音。
When Lord Jesus have ascended into the heaven, in the book of Acts, the apostles, they have been spreading the gospel.
然后呢，这些犹太的官长呢，就禁止他们。
And all these Jewish rulers, they try to stop them.
结果门徒就说，顺从神跟顺从人，应该怎么做？你是顺从神啊，顺从人啊？所以这里是有一个，如果神的旨意跟人的那个法令啊或者什么东西冲突的时候，我们就要顺从神而不是顺从人。
And then the apostle discussed that, should we obey God or obey the local authority? And when there's a conflict, we must choose God.
所以态度上我们要顺服他们。
Therefore, in attitude, we obey them.
要尊荣他们
，and we respect them.
但是在实际的情况下，如果他们的东西 是违反神的命令的时候，我们就顺从神而不顺从人。
But in actuality, if the things they're doing goes against God, then we obey God and we don't obey them.
也照样在家庭也是这样。
It's the same matter in our family.
如果你的父母，只要他们是父母，你就要顺服他们。
If they are your parents, then you have to obey them.
但是你知道有一些父母啊，叫自己的孩子啊，就是去，因为小孩子小嘛，到超市里头去偷东西。
But you know, some parents, they teach their kids because they're young, they're small, they tell them to steal from the supermarkets.
那如果他这个小孩子已经信主了，他是要顺服他的父母呢，还是不顺从他的父母呢？
But if these children have already believed in God, well, should the children obey God or obey their parents?
他当然应该顺从神的教导。
Of course, the children need to obey the teaching of God.
所以这，但是有一些这个不信的人，他们就滥用这个顺服，这个圣经里头顺服的原则，强迫人去做违背神的事情。
But some non-believers, they use this line in the Bible to obey the parents to force people to do things.
所以这里希望神给我们有智慧，我们要掌握如何在态度上顺服他们，但是在实际上我们要顺从神的教导。
So over here, may God give us the wisdom that in attitude we obey them, but in actuality we obey God above all.
Okay, 最后，在处理这些关系的时候呢，我们要追求一个彼此和睦。
And lastly, in managing these relationships, we have to look for harmony with between each other.
我们在与神的关系上，我们要追求与神和好。
In our relationship with God, we have to look for to be in harmony with Him.
我们怎么样能够和与神和好呢？神是圣洁的，我们也要圣洁。我们圣洁就能够与神和好。
So how can we restore our relationship with God? Our God is holy, therefore we need to be holy and cleansed.
在家庭里头呢，我们怎么样才能够和睦呢？
And in our family, how can we be in harmony?
就是我们要要忠实于我们的职守，我们要尽我们的能力来守住我们的本分。
In our family, we have to beFaithful and determined to follow our duty by God.
然后记得，有任何的事，有任何的话，会破坏这种和睦的，我们不说也不做。
And remember that any words and anything that will destroy this relationship and harmony, we don't do it.
你明明知道你讲这句话，虽然你讲的是这个事实的话，实事求是的话，但是你讲出来。你知道对方一定跳起来，你就不要讲。
If words you speak, you know it's the truth, but you know that it will anger the other, then you will not say it.
你做一件事，你知道这件事就会使到这个家起波浪、起风暴，你就不要做。
And if you know that the thing that you're going to do is going to cause destruction to the family, then you will not do it.
在教会里头也是这个原则。
And in the church, it's the same.
我原来在澳洲有一个牧师，那个牧师，我在他的教会里头侍奉。
Back in Australia, there's a pastor that I served in his church.
然后呢，他就跟我讲，他说，我在教会里头，我不知道老是有这种倾向。我讲这句话，本来大家都好好的，我讲这句话，大家吵架。
He said that in church, I always have to start that whenever I speak, everyone is normal, but after I speak, everyone start arguing.
他说不知道为什么我老是会这样做。
He said, I don't know why, but it always happened after I speak.
过后我非常的后悔，但是我当时讲的时候我很开心。
He said, afterwards, I regret it a lot, but when I was speaking the words, I, was happy about it.
所以我们在教会里头会破坏教会的和睦、教会的合一的话和事，我们虽然啊，我们做了之后可能会我们自己觉得啊，好像很痛快，千万不要做。
Therefore, in church, any words or things that will destroy the unity of the church, even though we might feel good for doing it, like we must refrain from doing it.
在国家里，在一个政，这个我们现在美国，如果你觉得你在网上发表什么言语或是怎么样，会让这个国家不平静或是什么，我们就不要做。
It's the same in our government. If you feel like the message you put up online will cause conflict in this nation, then we don't do it.
这个使我使大家能够彼此和睦这个原则，我们一定要记住。
And to be in peace and harmony with each other, these principles we have to remember.
好，我们最后来唱一首诗。
Lastly, let's sing the hymn.
求主来检查我们，我们里面是不是有一些东西会破坏家庭，我们与神之间或者任何情况下的那种和睦，求主来检查我们。
Let's say, search me, O God, and let us examine ourselves that if we have anything within us that might cause destruction to the church or our family, let God examine us.
请起立。
Please rise.
Thank you.
感谢神，也感谢牧师为我们分享如此宝贵的信息，让我们再一次的学习尊敬和尊荣这个功课。
Thank the pastor and thank God for giving us such a great message that we once again we are able to review the lesson of respect and honor.
首先我们是要绝对尊崇神的权柄，我们要尊主为大。
First of all, we have to absolutely obey the authority of God and honor our Lord as the highest.
而且在我们的生活中，不管是在家庭还是教会中，我们也要尊重和尊荣别人，
and,
用爱去爱别人，因为神先爱了我们。
And in our everyday life.And in church, that we have to respect and honor others and love them because God has loved us first.
而且我们是要以和睦为原则来维持我们所有我们的关系中，要用爱与和睦来对待别人。
And we have to have the principle of peace and harmony in.Managing all our relationships.
我知道都对每个人都是非常的难做到绝对这样子就求神来帮助我们。
And I know it's truly hard to do 100%, but may God give us the strength.
感谢神。
Thank God.
好，下面我们来分享我们的家事。
Now we.
我们知道在座的大部分的我们的弟兄姐妹都是就喜欢参加我们有英文的那个查经班，是由长老带领，每逢礼拜四的晚上希望大家可以踊跃参加。
So there's the Bible study by Debbie every Thursday. If you have not attend, please attend.
还有我们每个礼拜三的晚上八点，还有礼拜五的早上七点都有那个祷告会，也请大家如果有时间也可以参加。
And we also have the prayer meeting every Wednesday at 8 p.m. and also Friday at 7 a.m. in Mandarin. If you are willing to, you're welcome to attend.
好，下面请牧师给我们做祝福的祷告。
Now let's have Pastor give us the benediction.
让我们用信心来接受从上帝而来的祝福。
Let's receive the blessing from God with our faith.
愿主耶稣基督的恩惠、父神上帝的慈爱、圣灵的感动与交通。与我们同在，从今时直到永远。
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of the Father, the fellowship and communion of the Holy Spirit be with us from now till eternity.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated and you may be dismissed after a moment of silent prayer.